Okay, so it turns out there's another application of the second derivative, and maybe you were thinking this with the pictures that I drew the last time. So let me kind of redraw them, and then I think you'll see. So the last time we talked about this sort of shape, and we said that this was the idea of a graph being concave down, right? And for this one, f double prime is negative, right? Okay. And okay. And it was never a problem for me to remember this connection between down and negative and up and positive. That always kind of made sense to me. But the other thing that you might see visually here is that with these, you can sometimes get a point exactly like that, which we had talked about with the first derivative to be a relative maximum, right? So we still have to identify these points. This point is still a point where f prime is 0, right? So I still have to identify them by f prime at some point c is equal to 0, and then the second derivative at that point should be negative. And these two conditions together are the second derivative test for a relative max. Okay? And similarly, if I have this sort of shape, and I have this point that should be a relative min. Again, here f prime should be 0. This is the shape where this is right concave up, and f double prime is positive. So in this test here, I need f prime of c again to be 0. These are my critical values, you remember? And f double prime of c to be positive. And when that happens, then I get a relative min. Okay. Now I want to make a quick note just so that you know, if f double prime at this point is equal to 0, or if it's undefined, then the test fails. And it doesn't tell you anything. It doesn't tell you if it's not a maximum. It doesn't tell you if it is a maximum. The test just fails, and you don't get relevant information out of it. Okay? So let's do an example together. And I want to go back to the example that we were working on before. This function f of x is equal to 2/3 x cubed minus 4x squared plus 6. And I want to use the second derivative. To find relative extrema. You remember we were saying with the first derivative, these are not globally high points or globally low points, they're just points that look high locally. Okay, so the first step in this solution is to, one, identify critical points, critical values. Not hypercritical values, just critical values where f prime of x is equal to 0. Just the first derivative, okay? So take the first derivative. We did that before, we'll do it again. 2/3 times 3x squared minus 8x. And this was 2x squared minus 8x, right? And I need to solve. Oh, I almost forgot. F prime of x equals 0, or what else? F prime undefined. Don't forget that, like I did. Okay? So those are the two places that critical values can come from. Okay, now when I look at this function, I have this nice polynomial function here. So there's no place where f prime is undefined, but it could be 0, so I'll set it equal to 0 and solve. And I get x equals 0. And x is equal to 4. Okay? Okay, so I want to, those are my two critical values. Instead of making this big chart, the second derivative test says, okay, that's fine. Find the second derivative, find f double prime at your, and I'll put in here the critical values. Okay? So I'll do that down a little bit. I know f prime of x is equal to 2x squared minus 8x, right? So f double prime of x, and we found this before, 4x minus 8, right? So now, for x is equal to 0, one of my critical values, I plug in f double prime of 0 is equal to negative 8, right? And then for x is equal to 4, f double prime of 4, f double prime of 4. And these are two values that I randomly chose in our last chart, because that was unintentional. All right, so here we go. We have these two critical values, and I have this now. Now, the thing that you want to notice is here, f double prime is negative. That means it looks like this, and I get a relative max. Okay, here it's positive, concave up, and I get a relative min. Now, I do need to find what the actual function values are here, remember? Like, the relative maximum is the output value. So let's go through that. So f at 0, the original function at 0, and this f of x, let me remind you, 2/3 x cubed minus 4x squared plus 6. And so you plug in 0 here. So f of x has a relative maximum of 6 at x equal to 0. And then over here, let me plug it in, f of 4, 2/3, 4 cubed minus 4 squared plus 6. Let me use my calculator for that one. It's a little bit more complicated. I get negative 15 and a third. I think that's negative 40. Is that negative 46 thirds? Let me check it. Yeah, negative 46 thirds. So f has a relative minimum, right, of negative 46 thirds at x is equal to 4. Okay? So this is the second derivative test for relative maximums and relative minimums. You find the critical values from the first derivative and then just plug in those values into the second derivative and see if it's positive or negative. Okay? So let me know if you have questions about this.